First, let's read out the comment from the user who are using iOS 15.1 RC build. I am using iOS 15.1 RC on my 10s Max and I must say that is very stable. Next, I'm using it on my primary device iPhone 13 and it seems absolutely awesome. No bugs, good battery and it's really stable. Version is 15.1 RC and the phone is iPhone 12 mini. Works great for me. I also discovered some new feature with this version of my new AirPods Pro. Next comment. No major issues, much more stable than the first version of iOS 15. It also fixed storage bug on iPhone 6s. iOS 15 is a lot more stable on my iPhone SE though. On the RC 15.1, 12 Pro Max, no major issues I have found so far. Seems like the touch issues was resolved. These were the comments from the user who are already using iOS 15.1 RC build, which is the closest beta to the public release. And it seems more stable with good user experience and lot more. Now the question is, should you install the iOS 15.1 on your device? Hello everyone, I'm Nikhil from iGeeks Blog and today Apple released the iOS 15.1 public release. And now the question is, what are the new features, bug fixes and should you install? Let's find out with this video. First, let's talk about the feature and the first on the list is SharePlay. At WWDC, Apple introduced the SharePlay feature in iOS 15 and with that, we can share videos or music with other users on FaceTime call. This is a great feature. However, before iOS 15 public release and in developer or public beta 6, Apple removed this feature and with iOS 15.1, this feature is here. And now we can enjoy video and music with our loved ones. The next major feature update is for iPhone 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max user and that is ProRes support. In iOS 15.1, Apple enabled to capture videos in ProRes format on iPhone 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max camera app. To activate it, head over to Settings, Camera, Format and over here, toggle on the switch next to ProRes format. The next feature is again for iPhone 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max and that is Macro Mode. In previous version of iOS 15, when the iPhone gets close to an object, it switches to Macro Mode automatically. Now in iOS 15.1, we have an option to turn on or off the auto switch to Macro Mode. Not only this, iOS 15.1 brings a lot of happiness, joys and more bug fixes. And the most annoying and confusing bug in iOS 15 is about storage. Many of us have seen iOS 15 and system data is acquiring a lot of space on iPhone, which was actually not that freezes the storage on iPhone. In this new update of iOS 15.1, this bug is fixed. Thanks Apple. On a few models of iPhone, many users felt touchscreen responsive issue. Actually, I didn't feel that issue. However, this bug is fixed in the RC build and continued in iOS 15.1 public release. Do share your valuable comments below and tell me, are you facing this issue again or any other bug? Now, let's talk about the battery drain issue and many iPhone 6s, SE and even a few iPhone XS and a XR user had this issue. Apple has addressed this issue and now we can see a better battery life in iOS 15.1. Also, we can notice a bug fix about the loss of audio during a call and that we will experience after using iOS 15.1 day by day. Stay tuned by subscribing to my YouTube channel and I'll keep you posted about the new updates and feature in iOS 15. Now the question is, should you install iOS 15.1 on your device? My answer is yes, just because it has a great performance, better battery life, major bug fixes, new features like SharePlay, ProRes video, macro mode and lot more. And this is amazing. And I must say, you must install it and you will have a great experience of using iOS 15.1 on your device for sure. And I'm not saying this, the user who are already using the RC build of iOS 15.1 had a great experience. And I already shared a comment from those users as well. And they are also commenting and saying that, okay, it is good to go and we can install the iOS 15.1 on our primary device. Now, what about the iOS 15.2? When Apple will release? Hold your breath just because betas are yet to come and I'm expecting the first iOS 15.2 beta in the earlier next week. I hope you like this video. If you did, then please give a big thumbs up to this video. Stay tuned with me by subscribing to my YouTube channel just because I'm keeping an eye on everything Apple and will keep you posted about what's happening in the Apple industry. And along with that, download my iGeeks Blog app to enjoy exclusive content about everything Apple. Now, allow me to say goodbye. I'm Nikhil signing off. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay connected.